Does everybody have a Bible? Does everybody have a Bible? come to know. I want you to take your Bible with you. I'm going to
without grace.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Thank you. God has put, now listen to this. Maybe you haven't seen this yet. Let's just look at it. I want you to look at it. Look right now. If you'll do it God's way, this is your year. According to His principles. Come on. I promise you that I'm going to preach the Word. I want to know nothing but Christ and Him crucified. I want to give you the Word of life. I don't want to come with a gimmick. I don't want to come with some kind of a scam. I'll build on a solid foundation, not an experience. Oh, I love the experiences, but they come. And we'll have plenty of those experiences. But we're not going to build our church on experiences. We're going to build our church on the Word of God. The Bible says, teach the Word. Be instant, in season and out of season. It's His Word that is the sure foundation. Not the gifts. I love the gifts. We're going to have plenty of them. Not healing. I love healing. But that's not the foundation of the church. It's part of it, yes. We need healing. And I'm going to let you know what? I can get you healed, but if you don't have enough Word to keep your healing, you'll be sick again. I can get you prosperous, but if you don't have enough integrity and character of the Word of God, you'll lose your prosperity. The Bible says that all Scripture is given by God for doctrine, reproof, correction, and instruction in righteousness. That the man of God might be thoroughly furnished unto every good work. That he might be thoroughly furnished to produce something. We're going to look into the perfect law of liberty. And the Word of God is going to set us free this year. This is another year. Tell your neighbor it's another year. Tell your other neighbor, it's another chance. You see, it's a chance to repent. It's a chance to produce. It's a chance to apply yourself. This year is not about you, but it's about getting your life together with others. It's about getting your life together in proper order, proper relationship, proper governance, under authority, in authority in the appropriate seasons. Under authority in the church. Under authority at your place of work. In authority in your home. In authority over your children. In authority over your business. In authority in the spheres where you are in authority and under authority where you're under authority. Aligning yourself properly. Governing yourself under the authority of the Word of God. Why did God give us new year, another year? Because He has something for you to do. He has something for you to do. That's why you haven't been killed. That's why you haven't died. I've got to tell you, God's not through with you yet. Redeem the time, the Bible says, for the days are evil. We live in perilous times. Leave it alone one more year. Just leave it alone one more year. Why should it use up the soil? Why should it waste precious soil? Leave it alone for one more year. Why shouldn't we just cut it down? Leave it alone for just one more year. Hedge it in. See, when the devil contested for Job's life, he told God, he accused God. He says, you've hedged him in. You've hedged Job in. The devil says, take the hedge down. If you take the hedge down, he'll curse you. Can I tell you something? You're in this house. You're hedged in. If you're here, you're hedged in. You're in a vineyard. God planted you here. God planted you in a vineyard. The church is the vineyard. God says you are the planting of the Lord. You're not here by accident. If this is your church, then grow. Produce something. Produce something. Pay your tithes. Give your offerings. Give your service. Give your fellowship. Give your love. Produce something, not only for yourself. It's not about you. It's for others. It's for everything else. Make this your year to be productive. Let's not come back here next year and find ourselves lamenting those that are not with us that was chopped down. Lamenting those that, oh, maybe you didn't die physically, but you died spiritually. You're no longer with us. You withered. are cut off from the vine. You're in a vineyard. You're in the vine. Produce. Produce. This tree, for 3 years, had no fruit. 3 years it had no fruit. And the owner said, cut it down. How long has it been since you've really borne fruit? It's time to bear fruit. Don't tell me about it. Show me. Don't look good. Be good. Don't look prosperous and then never give. Be prosperous. Be giving. Be liberal. Don't look full of fruit. Never bless anybody. Bless people. Don't tell me about your gifts. Use them. It's your year. It's your year. Come on, say this out loud. It's my year of fruitfulness. I'm going to bear fruit this year. This is my year to bear fruit. Dung me one more time, Lord. Dung me. You know what dung is? Put the dung around the tree one more year. Just put the dung around the tree. You know what the dung is for you? The Word of God. It's the fertilizer that will cause you to grow. Will you do it? I had a friend who was a drug addict. He's a great preacher today, but his drug rehabilitation instructor looked at him one day and he said, Casey, you're going to fake so hard one time that you're actually going to get it together. Some of you have been faking for so long. You've been trying to look like you're bearing fruit for so long. But every time we come, there's still nothing. Stop faking. This year, let's bear some real fruit. It'll come with pain. I can tell you right now, you can't bear fruit without some kind of pain.